The puppies are ready. We are doing Elder Scrolls Online, and I apologize, I couldn't find my cloak, my cape, so I couldn't do my cosplay. Sorry. But to make up with it, we're gonna make some damn delicious food today. So we're gonna be doing some millet rolled pork loin. I'm gonna show you what we're gonna learn together, because I've never done it before. We are going to roll our own pork loin together. We're gonna fill it with cranberry and apple, and it's gonna be damn delicious. We're also gonna continue on with making an oxtail stew, something that I grew up with my grandmother. She made the most phenomenal. She doesn't cook that often, but her stews and her soups are the bomb. So something that I love is oxtail, and we're gonna do a different version. We're gonna do Jamaican style, so spicy, really full of garlic, allspice as well. It's gonna be really, really tasty. And then we're gonna finish off with an ESO classic. We're gonna do baked apples, and then we're gonna fill them with some crumble, or like apple crisp, but in a baked apple. It's gonna be today for. But before we go into that, let's go back to last time, and we'll show you what we got up to. Let me unlock my iPad here. There we go. So we did another episode for Link. So tonight's episode is for Link, and it's his... I'll go into that in a minute. So we did a slumber party, kind of like adult pajama party. I was in my pajamas, terrible. I didn't realize what I looked like until I went on stream, but that's another story. We made our own homemade potatoes, potato chips. We marinated them in some olive oil, some salt, and then we also made some rosemary as well to die for. Very, very yummy, crispy, crunchy. We made some pancake dippers, and they had bacon in there, like slices of bacon, as you can see at the top, and then dip them in maple syrup. So hot chocolate, so we made an anti-inflammatory hot chocolate, like a healthier version, perfect for the winter months, trying to like ward off the cold and the flu that everybody has. So it was full of cinnamon, nutmeg, ginger, cardamom as well. Perfect to kind of keep you going. I had some cayenne pepper to increase your metabolism, just to get rid of the inflammation, get rid of all the nastiness, like the bugs and things like that. And all in a hot chocolate, it was so good. And then we topped it with some marshmallows and used our blowtorch to toast them. And we made some cream cheese brownies. So they were chocolate brownies swirled with cream cheese, and very yummy as well. My only regret is I should have put more cream cheese to make it more like a cream, like a cheesecake layer. I was a little bit nervous, but they were very, very yummy. I think they have all gone because Xie must have eaten them, because I didn't see any in the fridge. We received 4 subs, so I ate 2 warheads, follows and hosts. It was a lovely stream. Let's bring that chat up. Thank you already for those bits. Bella and Betsy, thank you very much, everybody. It is a little bit distracting when you guys do that when entering my intro, but it's all good. How is everybody doing? Hello, Bella, Mason, Link. How you doing, Brayden? So we have JTW, how you doing? We have a little bit of an announcement. It is Brayden's birthday today, as well as it being a stream that for him. Happy birthday, Brayden. Some birthday cheer. Can we get some love and some hype in the chat, please, for Brayden? Link Nightblade. It is a stream for him because He redeemed enough Molly dollars to choose a theme, and he chose ESO, so Elder Scrolls Online. It is a, I always get confused with saying this out loud, massive multiplayer online role-playing game. That's it. Did I get it right, Exceed? I'll make good on my promise now. Yes, we're very excited. And what we're going to start doing is having a community calendar so we can celebrate everybody's birthdays. Link did tell me as soon as I said to him, themed cooking stream tonight. She's cooking three dishes from a long list of foods you can in TS... Oh, the Elder Scrolls Online? TSO? Okay. TSO. Oh, I'm missing something. So what we're gonna start doing is doing a community calendar of everybody's birthdays. So if people wanna send Exceed a message and let us know in chat if that might be easier for Exceed, just your birthdays, and he's gonna note them on our calendar, just so that we can give you guys some love on your birthday. I know that we have missed some people in the past, but as it is a new year, we're gonna start celebrating and having some fun with it. Okay, so tonight, we're gonna go into our pork loin. And this is a more expensive cut of meat than I was thinking. It's a roast, like a loin. And what you do is you will butterfly it out so it flattens out. So it goes from like this to roll it out, like cut it out. And then we're gonna stuff it. We're gonna make a stuffing full of panko breadcrumbs. Cranberry, millet. If you don't have millet, you can use brown rice as well. Some walnuts, shallots, maple syrup, rosemary, and we're gonna roll it back up, put it, tie it, and then put it back in the oven. So it's gonna be yummy, very, very yummy. That would be super cool. Yeah, so give us your dates. Give us your birthday, guys. I just had some water here. How are you, Apple Accent? Can I have my Dota water bottle? I know, Betsy, but we just need the date to write it down. Open Gangnam Style. Link, thank you so much for that resub. 5 years in a row. So exciting. It's lovely to have you here. You're a very, very important part of the community. So thank you again for all your support. I said, Exceed Man, thanks, Mason. There, now I'm not going to miss anything. December 17th. Thank you. Thank you, Betsy. Okay. So what we're going to do is this is our pork loin, as I said. Yuki, hello. August 27th. Nice. Could you make lumpia? Yuki, thank you so much for that follow. Could you make lumpia? Lumpia, is that how you pronounce it? Sometimes my grandma makes it and gives it to me for my birthday. I will have it. I don't know what it is, but can you tell me what, explain it? Okay. What we're gonna do, it's rather than use our big chopping board, we're gonna prepare it on here. Take that one away. So, this is a pork loin, boneless pork loin, you can see. Okay, we have a nice big sharp knife. What I'm gonna do, so my chopping board doesn't slip, I'm gonna jump down here. It's always at this time, about 7 to about 8 o'clock, Chester and Romeo decide that they want to play together. I think they get up from their afternoon sleep, they eat, and then they're crazy. Crazy dogs. Okay, so I'm going to put a damp cloth. Oh, that's going to go on there. A bit more stable. Is it yummy? I don't know much of what it is, but pronounce loom. Google, what's Lumpia?
According to Wikipedia, lumpia is a spring roll of Chinese origin, commonly found in Indonesia and the Philippines.
Ooh, Yuki, that sounds amazing. I do like, I haven't actually made spring rolls in, I don't think I've ever made them. I don't know, maybe, I haven't made them in a long time, if not ever. It's basically an egg roll without the egg. It's actually got pork or something, sort of meat, lettuce, and carrot wrapped in lumpia wrapping. Oh, okay. I'm keen. All right. I will get Exceed, or if someone can send that to me, I will. Rory's looking for something fancy and new to make. Something different. That is, so for the people that are new to our stream, we have this theme stream, which is Gamer Grub, where we make food from video games, TV shows, and movies. So, like Elder Scrolls Online, we're gonna recreate some of the food. They don't necessarily have recipes, so we just kind of make it up as we go, or I find recipes and I just, from my research. Or we also have Miss Molly Makes Around the World, where we do themed cuisine. So, very interested in making some lumpia. That sounds good. Thank you very much for that idea. Thank you, Bella. Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry. I did miss that. I was in the middle of thinking. Thank you so much, Bella, for that tweet. So, guys, you can tweet this show. Just hashtag Miss Molly Makes in the tweet, and it comes up on screen. Thank you, Bella. How are you? I'm very excited. I have to say, I'm very excited, Bella, for your cooking stream. Okay. Recreate the food from the anime Foodwood. Oh my god, the pork, bacon pork. Ooh. Make sure you guys join our Discord, our community on there, and there's stream suggestions. I'd love to see them in there, and that puts it in a centralized area so I can flick through there and see things that people suggest. So it sounds great. Food Wars, okay. All right, so this is our loin. What I'm just doing is taking this twine off, and I've also gone and bought my own cooking twine. So we're just gonna tie it up. So it's gonna, in the oven, it's going to look like this. But what we want to do is we want to roll it out and cut it so that we can roll it back up. That makes sense. If I can get it all together, you will. If you need any help with anything, let us know. Or let Exceed know. Okay, Exceed, if you can scroll down a little bit. Okay. So you can see that this is rolled out already. But what we want to do is bring our knife around to then make some more space. It's not unusual, you want to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual, you want to have fun with anyone. Thank you, Link. Thank you, Brayden, for that donation. Very, very kind of you. Very much appreciated. Goes back into our Molly Fund for updating some equipment, also towards our groceries. I had some spare change that I'd never used in my paper. Well, it's very much appreciated. Thank you very much, Link. Okay. So what you want to do is just nice slices through this loin. Stuff to you know, improve this room always, but, you know, to change around some things that we have at the moment. So all the money is much appreciated in a bit. You know, you guys are an amazing community. I'm just getting a little bit bored of the layout and things. So I just want to try some new things. I don't know what we'll do. But the thing is that I like the camera to be a little bit closer, like it used to be in the old kitchen, but then we knock out some of the, like, you know, you come too close and then it's not as wide of an angle, so you don't see this green screen or you lose this green screen. So I'm just figuring out how to do it. Pirate, how you doing? We love the stream, thank you. Okay, so that is the butterflied pork. You can see it's nice and rolled out. It's not as, like, fancy as they do, everybody. But what's gonna happen is we're going to fill it in here. We're gonna lay it with our stuffing, what we make in a few minutes. Lay it out, roll it back up like this. And then what you do after that is you get your twine and you hold it together. And then we bake it. So what I'll do is just hold it like that. And then we'll prepare the rest of our stuffing. So I'm gonna preheat my oven to about 230 degrees Celsius or 450 Fahrenheit. Want a nice hot oven. If you have a fan forced oven, you're probably looking at around 180, 190 degrees, depending how big your oven is as well. It's one of those things, it's better to go a little bit lower or just check it more often, because especially when we went from the old kitchen to the new kitchen, we had a really big oven. It would take a lot longer to heat up, and it was very different cooking in a small oven like this. I found that things would cook a lot faster, especially being fan forced, that would be cooked on the outside and not as, you know, they'd still be a little bit soft in the middle, especially with cakes. So now I've learned to turn my oven down lower, just to ensure that it's an even cooking process, okay? Adam, how you going? Happy New Year, thank you very much. Lovely to have you back, Adam. Okay, so our filling is going to consist of, let me get a bowl. We want some apple. We're also gonna stuff, I might just do one apple actually. Let's find the worst one because we're gonna stuff the other ones. So I think we'll keep these three big ones for the for the baked apples. We'll keep, cut this one up for stuffing. This is a Granny Smith apple, it's nice and tart. So that will allow some nice, you know, sweetness and a little bit of different flavor when you're in contrast to your meat. You want that nice bit of tart to kind of cut through the fat of the pork, and then it will also go really well with the sweetness of the cranberries, the crunchiness of your millet, as well as the walnuts as well. It's all gonna work really, really well. It tastes so good. So, let me just get millet on my fridge. Okay, so what we're gonna, see if we can, oh no, that's fine. All right, in here we want half a cup of panko breadcrumbs. So I have decanted my massive bag of panko. Those that have been here for a while knew that I bought panko breadcrumbs in bulk. So I've got majority of it in this container and then some leftover in the back of my pantry. Look, I tidied up my pantry. So it's all pretty organized. It's still getting there, but it's all in like more nicer containers and things like that. How was the fancy dinner? Oh my goodness. It's hard to believe that this time last year that we were at the Crown Casino. Last night we went to dinner by Heston Blumenthal. And it was like a not a fairy tale. It was an amazing experience. It was such a nice time to have, you know, a night out with Ixie. We got dressed up. We took an Uber into the city. And from everything, you know, from arrival, they were so professional. It was so lovely. We sat at the bar and they were so knowledgeable. It's not unusual, you want to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual, you want to have fun with anyone. Thank you so much, Brayden. Thank you for that donation. You don't have to do that. You're clearing out your gift cards. Oh my goodness. You're crazy. They were so knowledgeable, all of the staff. We sat at the bar and it was just this beautiful ambiance. It was a nice and dimly lit and romantic. And then you could see this massive kitchen. And Exceed and I just sat there and watched the chefs and they just looked so in control. Everybody had their station. There was about 20 chefs in the kitchen. The kitchen was immaculate. Everybody was, you know, pretty chill, and it was beautiful. And then we had some cocktails. So Exceed had this really nice beer that was poured in a beautiful wine glass, actually. But it was a beer that was made from a local brewery, but in conjunction with Dinner by Heston. So you could only find it there, and it was a really beautiful beer. I'm not a big beer drinker, but we are going to, what was I saying? Yeah, it was a really nice beer, and I'd love to go and check out the brewery. Even though we won't be able to find that beer, it would be really nice, like checking out some local breweries. And I had this cocktail called the White Cliffs. So for those that know anything about Heston, a lot of his practice is focused on history and bringing like old historical recipes and bringing them into the new age, and then introducing them to like modern techniques and things like that. So I had this one called Link Redeem Choose a Cooking Lights thing. Oh my God, I was just saying to Exceed, where does he get all these bloody moly dollars from? Thank you so much. Link, you have to tell me what you want to choose a little bit later. I have a stack of Visa gift cards with $2 or less on them. The most part are useless because everyone, yeah. Yes, I do. I do know that. I had, at Christmas time, I was checking all these Visa cards and I was like, has this got anything on it? Or has this good gift card got anything? She's like, nope, nope, nope. Or one had like $2 on it, but you couldn't buy anything with it. A lot of them don't do like split purchases, like split payments, so it's just worth throwing in the bin. So I have this cocktail called the White Cliffs, and the story behind it was when the settlers left the UK to come to Australia, like the free settlers as well as the convicts, the last thing that they would see as they left the UK would be the White Cliffs of Dover, as they would sail through, they would sail past through the French Channel, and what they said is the cocktail itself was very romantic, but very, you know, deep. And the chalk from the White Cliffs was matched with the champagne from France. And so they make their own chalk liqueur and had a little bit of sweetness in there as well, matched with the champagne, and it was just beautiful. And it was a little bit different to what I thought. It was lovely. So we had the cocktails, and then we got escorted to our table. They picked up our drinks, they escorted us, and they took our drinks with us, and we sat down, and we had this big table between the two of us. And it was really romantic. We had beautiful skyline view to our right, and the staff were amazing. The food was incredible. So we started with our entrees. So I had meat fruit. So what it was is it looked like an apple, or no, it looked like a mandarin, sorry. And what it was is a mandarin gel that was orange and 100% edible except for the stalk. So you had to take the stalk off. And then it was a mandarin gel But inside, when you cut through it, it looked like a mandarin. And as you cut through it, it had this beautiful, creamy, buttery pate served with this massive piece of crunchy, buttery toast. And it was just heavenly. And Exceed had a chicken oyster salad to start. And it was a little bit hard because a lot of the recipes are heavily on seafood, and Exceed doesn't eat seafood, so there was only probably two or three entrees that he could have. They were only vegetarian or the chicken oysters, but it was actually beautiful. And then we continued on, and I had a venison, a medium. It was like a beautiful medium rare venison served with pickled beetroot and pickled red cherries. And stalking Insta, yes. Sorry, I'm entranced by the stories of Heston. Yes, and then Exceed had an Angus steak with a mushroom jam and a thyme. Angus steak with a mushroom jam and a thyme jus, and that was served with chips as well, or fries. And then we couldn't decide on dessert, so we had the top three desserts. So rather than have it, we had shared a beautiful bottle of wine that I will put on Discord. It was an incredible bottle it's a German wine, and lovely. So we drank that throughout, and then we had three desserts to share. So their most popular is called the Tipsy Cake, and I want to recreate this, guys. It is something that I've never really eaten before, and I didn't think that I would like a brioche cake. And then at the bottom, it's sitting in a ramekin, and at the bottom it has this creamy caramel sauce, and then it's served alongside it's like a rum caramel sauce, and then alongside a piece of pineapple, caramelized pineapple, that you can see as you enter, and then it's next door and just alongside the kitchen are these massive pineapples that are rotating like on a rotisserie, and the pastry chef every few hours or every few minutes will baste these beautiful pineapples, and they're glistening, and you can tell that they're all caramelized, so that they cut pieces of the pineapple off and they serve them alongside this cake. Oh, and it was to die for. And the second dessert was called Lamington cake. It was called a Lamington. So what it was is a cube or a rectangle of white chocolate mousse, I would say. Inside it would have some sponge cake with a raspberry jelly inside, and a caramel coconut mousse, I think, as well. And that was just, it's all very fancy, and it was sitting on the plate, and it was rolled in shredded coconut as well. Then I also had this really nice sauce, but Exceed said it was very too much rum for him and a bit boozy. And then lastly, we had a Vegemite ice cream. Aussies will know that it is one of our pride and joy. Our love of Vegemite carries through into the restaurant. And it was a beautiful ice cream served on popped, air puffed corn, I think. And all different types of, it kind of looked like little crunchy bits on the plate, with the ice cream on top. And then it was all about the drama of it all. So as they brought out our desserts, a third waiter would come, and he had this Vegemite pot, like a jar of Vegemite, and it said dinner by Heston. And then they had, like, you know how you have the honey pot, kind of, this one. Where is it, Dixie? Like the drizzler thing, like this. So they come out like this, and it says dinner by Heston, and it's got Vegemite in it, like they're probably their own blend of Vegemite that's made into more of a syrup. and then they like lather it over top of the ice cream. Oh my goodness, it was so good. So in order of preference, I would say probably the Tipsy Cake, then the Lamington. No, I'd say the Lamington, the Tipsy Cake, and then definitely the Vegemite was the third. But in my order of preference, I did love the Lamington the best. And yeah, we ended it and we walked and got an Uber and we came home to our boys. So it was a beautiful night. I don't know if I'm boring you with these stories, but it was an incredible experience. We're very, very lucky, and Exceed and I do a gratitude journal every day and every night. You know, our intentions for the day and also our gratitudes for that day. And it's just the ability to have an experience like that. I'm so grateful for Exceed of taking me and allowing us to experience it together. And a lot of you know, people, it's a hard restaurant to get into, I think, and it's been up there on my bucket list. And so yeah, I would like to go maybe another time, that's, you know, in the future, when I can save up for it and do the chef's table. So that is a special table that is set aside in the kitchen. It's like right in the kitchen, and the head chef will go through the menu and the reason for choosing the recipes and things like that, and the ingredients, and yeah, it was amazing. So that's what, yeah, it's like all wine paired and things like that, but that's for a long time, you know. It's my goal for my new bucket list. Looks like an amazing experience. It was. So if you guys want to see the photos, they are on my Insta, but I will post them on Discord and Facebook as well. Just from, you know, all of our food that we ate. There's a photo of Exceed and I, and some fun stuff as well. We'll get back into cooking. That's why we're all here. How you doing, Aaron? J-Mood, how are you? Oh, okay, now that's over. I see some ESO things, the inner nerd is emerging. Yes, yes, I couldn't find my cloak, so I couldn't do my cosplay. But please forgive me, we'll get into, that's my plan, is to be able to theme the kitchen a little bit more. I don't know how he does it. That alert is going, I just can't get the dance. It looks like I'm uncoordinated as crap. But thank you, Betsy, for those bits. Okay, so in here, in this bowl, we're gonna put half a cup of, if I can get these out, half a cup of panko crumbs, panko bread crumbs. And this is to kind of keep some of the moisture in. Romeo and Chester. Oh God. These two dogs. What is millet? Okay. Hey Google, what is millet?
Millet, a cereal grown in warm countries and regions with poor soils, bearing a large crop of small seeds which are chiefly used to make flour.
Hey Google, what does millet look like?
I heard, what does millet look like? Sorry, I can't show you pictures. I don't have a screen.
Google, please tell us. So yes, it is a cereal, very similar to like an oat or wheat, things like that. You can, if you don't have millet, definitely use, you could use oats, you could use brown rice. She's smarter than she looks. Yes, Betsy. Okay, back down here. Yeah, it's like just a grain. You can cook it, or you can get some millet flakes as well. So it looks like shit. What else am I doing in here? So we want a peeled apple. So this is a granny smooth, nice and tart. Very popular in baking. holds its shape nicely. I always wanted to be one of those people that could peel well and, you know, do the long strands. My grandmother, when we were kids, she cooks a lot and always was amazing. I always used to look at her and think, oh my gosh, I want to be able to, you know, she's so lucky. She can do all those big snakes of peel. And I'd still, like, I'm an adult and I'm still unable to peel an apple like she does. My adult goals to be able to peel an apple into a big long snail, like snake of snail. Speaking of snails, we're having an issue in our backyard with slugs and snails at nighttime, and I'm just not a fan of having them in the backyard when the dogs are around in case they lick them or eat them or whatever. So tonight is day one. I went and got some pet friendly slug and snail bait, and they're supposed to eat them and then crawl away and then die. So I'm hoping that works, because they're gross. They're like this big. The slugs are this big and fat. They're all like spotted and they look like snakes. Oh, God, just thinking about it makes me feel sick. So that's what I spent the day doing today. I also set up a rack, like shelf system outside, something that had been sitting there, and it's really crappy because it's a good shelving unit, but it comes in pieces, so it's like slats that you've got to like lock in, and it takes a lot of patience. So I only half made it, so it's got three shelves and it's this high, but usually it's got like six shelves and it's like that high. So I put all my my cucumber and zucchini on top of that, and then I did my blueberries and strawberries, and I got some soil and covered the holes where Chester has been trying to dig. Had a productive day, and I also set up a fly trap because we have to keep the doors open for the dogs. We're getting a lot of flies in the house, so what I've done is got these two fly traps outside that attract the flies and keep them out. It's looking, it's working well. In one trap I've caught about 15 flies. Don't call Peter. Flies. Flies were harmed in the making of that. Yes. You need dog doors. Yeah, so I'm getting a dog door installed. It was organized in early December and it gets installed next week. So it's a new flywire door, fly screen door with a dog door in it. Today is Saturday or Sunday? Yesterday was our first day of puppy preschool. Yesterday we went to puppy preschool. We arrived and everybody was already there, and we walked in and they're like, are you here for puppy preschool? I'm like, yep. They're like, you're late. I was like, okay. She said, the class started at 10 and we rocked up at 10:30 and it goes for an hour. So we missed half of the class, and you don't bring the dogs the first day. So I felt like a bit of a dick. But the trainer seems nice. So we'll see. Let's see how we go. Leopard slugs, big and Pacific. The size of basils, they're long. So they're like that thick and that long. They're so gross. You can make a bird and greenhouse combo. The birds will keep the slugs at bay. You reckon? Make a greenhouse though. Like a shelter. You wanna see the dogs? Jesse. Hello. You wanna see the people? So Chester came to the hardware store with me today. Come here. And with the new rule is they're allowed in the hardware store, but they have to be either held or you put them in a trolley in a box. Look how big he's getting. He's so big now. He's as big as Romeo. He's still skinny, like he needs to put on more weight, but he's very big. And Romy's here too. Mr. Romy. I wash my hands. And when they get a shell the size of the baseballs, the ones that are in our garden don't seem to have shells. There's snails, but the slugs just... I want to see Romeo too. Romy! I think they're playing in a minute. We'll, when they come around again. Hello. You think you're going to get food?
Hello, Tester.
Oh, hold on. Just come here. Happy New Year. Thank you very much. Happy New Year to you too. We are making some pork loin, Talexia soup. Pork loin baked apples are on the menu tonight. They are. Thank you so much for that tweet. Chester and Molly, yeah. Chester and Molly. Chester and Romeo, yeah. Okay. So we're chopping an apple. And what we're doing is making a stuffing. So we've got some panko breadcrumbs. We're gonna use our apple. I'm gonna put some stock in there today. So I made a bone broth. We're gonna be using some beef stock instead, just because I made a bone broth today. It was so funny. So it is so nice. Today I had the opportunity to actually do some cooking on stream. Hey Ori, how you doing? I did some cooking not on stream today. And it's one of those things that I feel like I need to do, because I just cook and don't have recipes, and there's no... there's no pressure, and I can just kind of do things in my own pace. Not that I don't do that on stream, but it's kind of using ingredients and not having to stick to a recipe. So today I made some tomato pasta sauce, made into like a shepherd's pie, and then also with some pasta as well. So I did some frozen meals and some lunches for Exceed and I. So that was like garlic, mince, ground beef, onion, a lot of garlic actually, some red wine, tomato paste, carrot, celery, and I simmered all of the ingredients for about an hour and a half, and it just made it so delicious and luxurious, and then I just served some with pasta, big those conch shells, like the pasta conch shells. And then also made some mashed potato as well. And it was just so lovely, doing broth and things like that off stream. I feel like I need to do that a little bit, like one day a week, just to kind of remember why I love cooking and not feel the stress of having to do things correctly, and you know, also do it in silence as well. It's quite funny. Not having to explain what I'm doing to an audience is different, but yeah. All right, so I'm going to put some this week to look at the food for the truck. No way, that's so exciting. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy for you. Okay, what else? We're also going to put some cranberries. Let us know how it goes. Yes, definitely, Ori. That sounds amazing. Congratulations, all your hard work is paying off. Good things are on their way. You want a third of a cup of dried cranberries. Yum. You want an onion. A recipe. If you do exclamation mark shop, I think, or store, it will tell you. We are going to be changing some stuff around with the store, so we're going to be increasing it a little bit so you guys get in early. Is it possible to lay down some copper wire or sheeting around the shelving or something? Apparently slugs. Yeah, so there is this slug wire that you can buy, but the slugs are on the grass. That's the only thing. They just like crawl around the grass, not necessarily on, I haven't seen them in the herbs. They're always just like walking around like on the grass. It's gross. Hello, sorry, need to go into lurk. I'm in the middle of a raid with another streamer. Okay. Strange Aussie, but that's all good. That doesn't tell me how much. Oh my god, eyes. Mason, if you actually just put them stream ideas into Discord if you want, because then they're in a centralized area that we look at. Or you can message Exceed, it's all good. Whatever you like. Oh my god. Okay, onion in there. I'm hoping they love everything. I'm making my boudin, sliders, crawfish, all potato salad, coffee brownie bites, and icy coffee creams. Hold on 2 seconds. Creams with fresh marshmallow and Nutella drizzle. We're making it every night this weekend. What do you mean? You're making all of this food every night just to make sure it's perfect? Is that what you mean, Ori? That's so cool. Rosemary in there as well. Yes, every nut. Oh my gosh. It just shows you know how much love you have for it and you want to be perfect. But don't worry, you know, if you cook with love and you cook, you know, with intent, it will be amazing and it will work out. You know it like the back of your hand. So just relax, enjoy the process of cooking it. So what day do they come? Done a destiny raid. Rosemary, you want about a teaspoon or a bit more like me because I don't follow. Alright, see if you want to scroll down a little bit in the recipe, please. Keep going. Alright, stop. Stop. Up, 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 stop. Also, we need some walnuts. Wednesday, and we are sitting down to negotiate contracts. Oh, that sounds exciting. So the walnuts are gonna add a nice bit of texture and crunch. So you're gonna have the sweetness of the cranberries, tart, and the sweetness of apples. Crunch of, you know, your millet as well as your walnuts. And we're going to add also a little bit of, tiny bit of maple syrup in there as well, honey. I'm going to add a bit more cranberry.
Okay, I've added cranberries to your shopping list.
There we go. Some salt. Clam cookies. I remember those were the reason I started watching your stream because I thought you were, oh yeah! Wow, that's the reason you started watching the stream. That's amazing. Because you thought, yeah, that was the Under the Sea stream. Little Mermaid Under the Sea. See? A raid, you know, someone else is hosting us and they come up on our channel, or you know, they just find us in all of a sudden. Interesting. Black beans? Where's black beans? Betsy? These are cranberries. Okay, so we're gonna get our pork. We'll go this way. Oh, will we? No. Didn't make enough. Okay. So what you want to do is get your stuffing. Push that down like that. Never done anything like this before. Here we go. And then last minute, a little bit more salt and pepper, just to ensure that you've got, you know, nice amount of seasoning. Oh, nice, Betsy. There we go. Sounds like some awesome way to recycle clam shells. Like you make a little cookie and you shape it as a scallop. Here we go. This edge here and then roll it. You want to be as tight as possible, guys. This is like a sushi. This is huge. I don't know if it's supposed to be this big. Please set up the affiliate link with the kitchen store. I think I have the gear there. I might have to change it. I will upload some stuff we have in our kitchen so you guys can check it out. Okay. One thing I can never do is roll California rolls. Oh my gosh! Oriverse redeemed. Choose a cooking lens theme. Thank you, Ori. The links below stream aren't working for you. Yes, yeah, so there should be the Google, no, sorry, Amazon gear. Okay, so now we've got some twine, what we want to use. Sorry. Every time I eat walnuts, they kind of get stuck in my throat. Okay, the most important thing is to find the end. Because there, yeah, beautiful. Okay. Let's try this out. I've seen my grandmother do this before, so it shouldn't be too hard. Oh God. Don't fall out. So you want to start in the middle first. Oh God. Make sure all your good bits don't fall out. When you need an assistant. Oh no, don't undo. Oh, I think we should go the Cajun theme. Yes. We've done some Louisiana style food, but I'm very excited to see what you want me to make, what you come up with. Sounds good. We should be able to source some of the ingredients. This is not as easy as I thought it was gonna be. The photo makes it look so easy. Maybe I stuffed it with too much shit. My bench is clean, by the way. Oh God. I don't want this stuffing anyway. So I managed to get my delicate and petite hands on those Lay's Kettle wasabi chips. What? I never heard of them. Your delicate hands. We do Cajun beer can chicken sometimes. Should be very easy. Most dishes have a trifecta of greens, pepper, onions, and celery. Nice. Well, maybe I should do it like that. Like we... That's better. Oh yeah, Molly, why didn't you do that the first time? So if you do it under, go over like that, cross it, and go around at least twice. It makes it so much easier to pull tight. Yeah. See, you learn things by just doing. So good. Okay. Are you still awake, Brayden? Brayden, Link Nightblade has a bad habit of falling asleep during stream. But that's not his fault because he lives in Canada and it's his birthday, so we can't be angry. Is anyone else besides me tired of the disaster movies coming out? I would never go see them. I'd never rent them, never buy them, never watch them on Netflix. Which one are you talking about, Betsy? The latest movie I saw, I think, was Justice League. And it was okay. I didn't love it. Talexi, did you figure out the Amazon gear? Can push this in here. All my stuffing's falling out, but it's okay. I kind of just push it back in. And the reason, just making sure these are spread out a little bit more. I love this one too. DJ wants to turn the music up. Too late. This is the song that put Riri on the map. I was reading currently the 9/11 after story one. I'll give you the name next time I get the ad. No time to read, 100% focus on Miss Molly. My wife told me off, wipe out. It's a comic one that's fine, entertaining, not depressing. Everyone told me. Okay. So now we're gonna get a roasting dish. Maybe you can go in this. This looks good. I'm gonna put some baking paper in. See, if you want to scroll down some more, please. So that will kind of keep its shape a little bit more. What I'm gonna do is pat dry and then put some J. Myers. Oh, that's okay. It's alright that you feel like the way. You could use whatever if you don't want to use oxtail or, you know, beef tail. You could just use any, like a cheaper cut of meat. More connective tissue, whatever you like. I know it sounds gross, but I do like oxtail. its way down. I don't want it to. So pat dry. We're gonna put some salt and some oil. Why is his tail so big? This isn't tail. This is a pork loin, my friend. So then we'll allow it to get, this isn't the tail, some nice crispiness going on. Sad, depressed about it. Title says tail. That's a huge tail. This is we're getting started with our pork loin at the moment, our rolled pork loin, and then next we're gonna do the oxtail. It's understandable, you know, some people don't know what it. This is oxtail like this, my friend. Beef tail. Thank you, Betsy. All right, in the oven, guys. Oh gosh, I won't put it in my oven. Take a shelf out. Oh, can't wait to have a nice big oven again. Done and dusted. All right, we're gonna get stuck into our oxtail stew or our beef stew. Beef tail stew. So to start, see if we can change the recipe. So this is the beef tail here. So I have a kilo. So a kilo of. Jay Myers, don't stress, it's all good. So we've got our pork here, we have some onion, garlic, we have some thyme. We're gonna do a Jamaican version, a little bit spicier, allspice, paprika, what else are we gonna put in there? The recipe calls for a Scotch bonnet chili. I don't have any Scotch bonnet, so I'm going to use this really, really hot sauce that I've got. But you can use like habanero, whatever you've got going on. Some Worcestershire sauce. This is just a fancier version of Worcestershire. Bouillon powder. So this is beef bouillon powder. Like a stock powder, whatever you like, whatever you've got. At the end, after we pressurize it, we're going to add some butter beans. So these are butter beans of fagioli. Francia? It's España. Butter beans. I wish your top right would stay what you're making instead of scrolling. Why? Why, Betsy? Yeah, that's, Jay Myers, that's so, so true. That, like, everyone's being a little bit unfair. Because if you don't know what oxtail looks like, then, or you don't know what certain foods look like, then you can ask questions. And I don't want you ever to feel as though you can't ask questions. And yeah. So this is a stew or a soup. So we're gonna be making it in a pressure cooker. So I'm just gonna go and get it. But what happens is it's like a beef soup or a stew. Stew is just a thicker type of soup. You have so many crazy ingredients. Yeah, so we're gonna do a Jamaican version. So we're gonna use some different spices. And a lot of flavor added in there. And what's gonna happen is you want more intense flavor when you're pressure cooking, because that will allow, or slow cooking as well, because the intense pressure can affect a lot of the flavors and dull them down. So when you're starting, you want more intense flavor, and that will equal out during the cooking process as well. So oxtail is very, very cheap. So it's about $7. It used to be much cheaper, but when food becomes fashionable, like pork belly and things like that, pork belly used to be so cheap. And now, because people are making fun recipes and it's becoming more popular, it gets more expensive. So this is a really tough piece of meat. It comes from the beef tail. It's got a lot of connective tissue, but that means that when you slow cook it or pressure cook it, a lot of this meat, these like connective tissue will break down, and it will go really melty and fall off the bone, and it is incredible. And you can thank ESO for introducing the crazy ingredients. Take a look at the provisioning skill recipe. Yes, Link, when I was looking through all the recipes, I was like, what do I, how do I even start? So I didn't want to make it too like wacky and weird for people, because I wanted to be able to use recipes that people had, access to. So oxtail is really, really delicious, and it is quite cost effective as well. The cheaper cuts of meats. If you're grossed out by oxtail or beef tail, definitely use ossobuco or some leg. So like you could use the same recipe with like lamb shanks as well. Just something that is, or a beef chuck that breaks down over time. So a really dense or a piece of the beef or the lamb or wherever that is being used all the time will be really, really tense when you cook it, because over time, if you start it low and slow for a few hours, it'll break down and it'll go really, really delicious and nice and melt in your mouth. Unfortunately, we don't have the time on stream to do slow cooking, so our way of doing it is we're going to use a pressure cooker. When you say tail, do you mean like something else? Cows don't have tails. Hey Google, where does a oxtail come from? All the time, great flavor. Oh, why's my Google going weird? What the hell? What's going on, Bella? Yeah, so, J-Mize, I will... Hey, Google, stop. The Google Home has gone weird lately.
On the website thekitchen.com, they say, in olden days, it came from the tail of an ox, but now it comes from the tail of a cow of either sex. The tail is skinned and cut into sections. Each section has a tailbone with some marrow in the center and a bony portion of meat surrounding the tail.
Get it? All right, so let me just go and get my pressure cooker. I'll be back in a few minutes, a few seconds actually. Kid is trolling. I know. It stumped me for a few seconds. I was like, what? It doesn't happen often. But being said, you know, I still want people to be able to ask questions, even if they're being dicky. Okay, pressure cooker. Let's just go to the stove real quick and check out. Get this out of the way. Can you guys see that?
Nope.
What? Nope, can't see it. It's all good. So our pork in the oven. Beautiful. Starting to smell delicious. I mean, you had to use your Google to explain where it come from. Yeah, because I want to get a better understanding and explain to you guys properly. You're so funny. Okay, so guys, in here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna season the oxtail itself. So I was listening, I was been reading some things about this Instant Pot. It's like a pressure cooker, right? What brand of pressure cooker are you using? I've never used one. They kind of scare me. Oh my gosh. So Talexia, I totally agree. And I've heard horror stories about pressure cookers. My grandmother has one that you put on the stove. And it freaks me out about, you know, leaving it on the stove. And she just like walks and sits down in the living room and watches TV. And I'm like, you know, you're always told in the kitchen not to walk away from anything on the stove and, you know, them blowing up and things like that. Well, this one here is called a Breville Fast Slow Cooker and it is amazing. So I'll show you, it has settings here that you can sear and saute. So that's what I do at the start. You only have to use one pan and it's removable as well. So you only have to sear it in here, and I'm not paid to say that. and you can sear it in here, and it causes less groceries. What the hell was that? Less groceries, less dishes, less dishes. So you can do everything in the pan. You can remove stuff. Sometimes I sear, take it out, add my fragrance, sear them, and then bring back the meat. But it is probably the best. You know, piece of equipment that I have, other than my KitchenAid and my food processor. It's so amazing. Hashtag butt open to sponsorship, yeah. And the thing is that you can use it as a rice cooker, a slow cooker, a pressure cooker, all in one. So this was kindly gifted to us by a beautiful, a beautiful viewer that sent it in to us. They don't want to be named, so we're very, very kind. It's just something that I wanted to be able to do slow cooked meals on stream, but in the like a portion of the time. And so pressure cooking, this will be done in about 40 to 45 minutes, and then you can just thicken it up just by, you know, you slow cook it, put it on back on sear, take the lid off, put it on sear, and then put some corn flour to thicken it up or reduce it with the lid off, and it's just on. I threw three fresh chicken breasts in there with spices and one cup of water. Set it to 9 minutes, shredded chicken for sandwiches. That's amazing. Oh, I never thought of that. That's such a great idea. Yeah, so Talexia, this is one I did a lot of research about. There is a pro model that was a little bit out of my price range. So it does a little bit more things. But if you didn't, this is probably, I think it's 160, but they, you know, you have sales all the time, but hands down, amazing, okay? So what you wanna do is put your oxtail in here. And, you know, things that would usually take 3 to 6 hours, you can do in half the time. I've made beef cheeks in under an hour from like preparation to finish and just, you know, melt in your mouth. The The ability to be electric as well, it's programmable. You can do a timer on it, and you can set it and forget it. I just put it, usually I'll put a chopping board on my stove over there and put it over there so you guys can see it on stream. You can do its thing, and then I don't have to worry about safety issues, because it has a valve inside it that it lets out the pressure if necessary, and you can't unlock it until it's depressurized. So it's got a quick pressurized valve or a button that you can push to let out the when it's the timer's gone, or if you just let it, you can set it and forget, like after, if you're at work or whatever, you can set it onto slow cook, and then it'll depressurize itself without you being there. And oxtail is delicious, for the record. Yes, Bella. That's the reason why I paid over $100 for my slow cooker. Yeah. So I actually got rid of my slow cooker because this is 6 liters, and it does, you can cook in it as well. You can roast, you can make cakes, puddings. I actually want to try, I've been doing research actually yesterday, how I can do different things in there and use it more on stream. So you can do cheesecake in there, puddings, cake, in about 4 or 5 minutes. And something that I love making in my oven is my chopped chip cookie dough cheesecake. And I thought, if I can do it in a fraction of the time in here, then just put some water, put it on like it's got an insert. There's like a wire bowl, a wire basket that sits in there, put some water, put the cheesecake in there, and then pressurize it, and it's so good. So if anyone has any pressure cooker recipes, or Bella, if you have any recipes, please let me know, because anything you guys want to try out, let's do it. The meat preference taken with a, considering your meat preference, this is taken with the greatest, exceed. Over 100, get one here for 30. Yeah, so all things are different, but Bella, considering the change in US dollars to Australian dollars, $100 for us would be, I think, about 65 to 70 US dollars. So yeah, it's all different. Family of five here, so a 6 liter is large enough, yeah. Yeah, it is great. And it's big enough to fit lamb shanks. I can do like a whole bowl of stock in there, bone broth, What, my whole life is a lie? Chicken nuggets don't have nuggets. So yesterday we were at the restaurant. Yesterday we were at the restaurant, and while I'm talking, let me do this. So I'm gonna set it to sear. And we're gonna just set it for like 10 minutes just to let it bubble. We're at the restaurant yesterday, and Exceed, when we were discussing the entrees, Exceed said he doesn't eat seafood, and there was one thing on the menu and it said chicken oysters, and he was like, she was saying that, that's got no meat, it's got no seafood, it's chicken, and he's like, okay, before I order, can you please just confirm to me, please? Chicken, where does it come, where does the meat come from a chicken, or I'm getting chicken and oysters? And she's like, no, it actually comes from like the back of the chicken, it's like a really small piece, it's really, really succulent. He goes, good, because I can't deal with chicken and oysters. Like, it just freaked him out. People come up with different names for things, and yeah. So this is going to heat up. What we want to do is we're gonna sear it. So that means you just wanna brown it all off. There we go. It's gonna start bubbling soon. Tonight is our first night of Molly and I's weekly wind jar. Yes, so Exceed, love the chicky oyster. So Exceed has got this idea. He hasn't explained it to me fully yet. But what we're gonna do is a jar. And get some pieces of paper, and every once a week we're gonna write a weekly win. So something that's happened that you're proud of, or a memory. And then next year on, I think, New Year's Day or something like that. We're going to read all of the incredible memories and things that happened and be, you know, give some gratitude for how amazing our year was. Bella, I thought chicken nuggets were made from cows and nuggets. Oh my God, Mason. So. Oh, before, you guys didn't realize, but I actually took a little bit of the pork out, some of the loin out, so that I could feel more stuffing in. So I'm actually going to cook this because I'm hungry, but this is just a piece of like pork loin, really tender and succulent. And we're just going to fry that up with some extra stuffing. Oh my gosh, this pork smells amazing. January 7th, found out cows don't have tails. Limping Lemon. I love that sentiment, more reason to make great memories. Hi, by the way. Hey, Lemon. You know what I said, Lemon? Do you know what I always think of? You know, 30 Rock. I always just, you know, Liz Lemon. That's what I always think of when I say your name. So, a little bit of the pork left over from our roast. I'm gonna fill in some stuffing. And the leftover stuffing. Probably a bit too much, but whatever. What are we making? Accusation! So we have our rolled pork loin in the oven. We've got lots of things on the go. We've got a pork loin that we've rolled, and we've butterflied it. We've filled it with cranberry apple, cranberry apple, walnuts, some millet, and then we've rolled that into a loin. We've tied it, and that's baking in the oven into a roast. We have oxtail here in the pressure cooker, just searing off, getting ready, because we're gonna make some Jamaican oxtail stew. And then also we've got some leftover pork loin that I'm just gonna cook up with some of the rest of the stuffing. We are doing an ESO, Elder Scrolls Online themed stream today to celebrate for Link Nightblade, or Brayden. It is his birthday as well, but he chose with enough Molly dollars to redeem and chose ESO. So this is the pork. A little bit of the leftover stuffing. We've got apples, cranberry, we've got some panko breadcrumbs, some stock, walnuts, yummy yummy. And then here we have our searing nicely our oxtail. Just getting a lot of caramelization, a lot of color going on. Pork loin equals beef tail. Guys, don't be smart. Don't be smart. Going back to lurking, cows do have tails. There's only a way to punch someone through the internet. So it's possible, Bella, you would still be in pain after the last stream when you called my barbecue chips and cottage cheese nasty. Oh, everybody's getting a little bit funny tonight. in this next shopping for this week, Mason, I actually bought cottage cheese, and I was thinking of you when I did it. It's for a recipe for Tuesday stream. We're doing spinach and ricotta, a healthy version of lasagna roll-ups, and they use cottage cheese. So that'd be pretty cool. Sending punch to Bella. Alright, that's gonna be our new thing. That'll be our new thing. We'll just get like, exhale, how you doing? Everyone will have a punch emote. You can just send punches to each other when people are being silly. And seared. Okay, so in here is going to go, that's our pork by the way. Cottage cheese in lasagna, it hurts my Italian heart. Don't worry, there'll be ricotta. Gosh, Bella, I'm gonna send a punch through the camera. It's been healthy, man. Look at how healthy. I'm gonna lose some molly weight. So you should have rested this. I always tell everyone to rest meat, but you have an extra dip of barbecue chip in it. Okay. Even smaller amount. Alright. It's a little bit pink, but you can eat whole pink. So good quality pork from a good quality, you know, a first world country, as well as, you know, free range or whatever. You can actually have the ability to eat pork pink. There was a long time ago in, you know, countries where the pork, and this is not necessarily in the US, I'm not sure, because your food standards are different to Australia, but here there is rigorous processes that go on with agriculture, and the pork has been proven that if raised well and in, you know, hygiene, you know, if it's a good quality piece of pork, then you can have it pink. They've changed the temperatures, the cooking temperatures, and then lowered them, so for an internal temperature that is safe to be eaten. So if you look it up, that's what I'm trying to say. Okay, in here, we want to add, let me put this pork aside. Let me just try it with, stuffing. Oh my god. Yum. 80s barbecue chips and cottage cheese. Slaps Bella and Exceed around with a large trout. Oh my gosh, it's getting nasty in here. Actually, like, remember that day where I cut my nail off, guys? Down to the nail, but it's growing out, but I just cut that nail off too. Crazy. Maybe I have some bad juju. What's going on? I'm cutting myself on stream. Hurting myself. Dumps cottage cheese on Bella. Oh my gosh. You guys are funny. Oh my gosh, the pork. Looking amazing. My eyes. Okay. Onion. Dude, we're gonna fight. Let's fight. That's a cool emote. Okay, garlic in there as well. What was that, Molly? Okay, one. I'm actually gonna put them in like quite whole. Savages, no. Walks over to Bella with barbecue chip and dips it. Oh, I love you guys. You make me laugh. So, for those that don't know, Mason and Bella have an ongoing argument about... Mason loves cottage cheese, and he dips in... His mum taught him to dip barbecue chips inside of... with the cottage cheese, and Bella thinks it's gross, so she told him on stream that it was gross, and now they're arguing about it all. Okay, in there we're gonna add some Worcestershire sauce. Oh, in with the whole thing. Okay, we want some thyme. That's just gross. I don't know. I like cottage cheese. It's like a healthy version of ricotta. My Italian friends and ancestors would probably kill me for saying that, but whatever. So that's allspice or pimento, paprika, thing I have that is pastry, and even that is whipped so hard it's smooth. Okay. So if you don't have a scotch bonnet or a really hot chili, just use really hot chili sauce. We're gonna get some tomato paste. I think I put that in the fridge. Some of this bouillon powder, beef bouillon. spoon. Some curry. I used to eat liverwurst and peanut butter sandwiches. Now I find that combo nauseating. Oh my goodness. Is liverwurst like sausage? Last but not least, we've got garlic, onions in there, our oxtail, chili, allspice, Worcestershire sauce, curry. Later on, we're gonna add some butter beans. I just need some spring onion or green onions. And as I said, it's going to break down over time in the pressure cooker. So, or you're slow cooking. So you can slow cook it for about, you know, just like this, put it in your slow cooker with some stock for about, I'd say about three to four hours in the slow cooker on low. Then what do we need? I'm gonna add about 6 cups of water or stock. I have some beef stock here in my fridge that I'm just gonna go and get. Mike Mason, you're out. Please don't say you're leaving because everyone's giving you a hard time about cottage cheese. Hey Pode, welcome back. Alright, so this is bean bone broth that I have made today. And it's very gelatinous. I'm just taking the oil, the fat layer off the top, just to purify it a little bit more. Just cooking snags on the new barbecue, the clean barbecue. Smoke. Chili, but we'll add some more chili. crank up that heat factor a little bit more. A bit more allspice as well. There we go. Okay. Last stir, we're gonna pressurize it on high and cook it for 40 minutes. So that means, whoop, I seal, I cleaned it the seal. There we go. There we go. And what we're gonna do, I need this stew in my belly. Okay. So then later on when it's ready, when we depressurize it, then we're gonna stir in some beans, okay, as well. I thought you were gonna put the curry spoon in your mouth by accident. Oh my gosh, hell no. Okay, what I do is I just get my chopping board. Put that there, put the pressure cooker on top. The only thing that I do all the time that I need to stop is I go to pick this up and bring it to you guys and I forget that it's plugged in. And I did that once and the lid was off, not on stream, and it splashed up and scalded all my arms. So, okay. So we're gonna go pressure and we're gonna press timer. We're gonna go 40 minutes, we'll go 45. And then we've got it on high. And so it just builds up to pressure and then the timer starts working. Okay, let's check on this. It's a bit hard. That is our pork at the moment. I'm gonna put a little bit more salt on the top. I should have scored it a little bit more, but it's looking good. Hey Google, what's the safe internal temperature for a rolled pork loin roast? Hey Google, what's the cooked internal temperature of pork loin roast?
160 degrees Fahrenheit.
Beautiful.
Here's a summary from the website blog.thermalworks.com. Brown pork should be cooked to 160 degrees Fahrenheit.
Thanks, Bella. So it's sitting at about 94 degrees right now. Still got a while to go. Okay. So we're gonna do our baked apples. So we've got three apples here. We're going to see if we can change the recipe. We're gonna stuff them with some rolled oats. Rolled oats. I'm gonna do some coconut as well, just because I love coconut in like an apple crumble or apple crisp. We've got some brown sugar. We've got some plain flour. Could add some nuts, some walnuts if you wanted to as well. Plain flour. Some cinnamon. Vanilla bean paste. Just gonna eat some more of this pork. Mmm, yum. Walnuts, and that's it. Georgie's gone to bed and left me with more summer sangria than I can drink. I got work tomorrow, damn. True link, yeah, just save it for tomorrow. Pody, to tomorrow your first day back at work? I bet you're looking forward to that. Not. Code loves, talks about how much he loves his job all the time. Okay. So what we're gonna do is make some crumble first in a bowl. And this, you have to stop yourself from eating. Brown sugar and oats and coconut is just the best. Back to the dungeon. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is we're gonna make our crumble topping. So we want half a cup of flour. So we've got flour, we want some butter, brown sugar. Guards look like they want to jump off. Oh my gosh. Oats. We're going to add some coconut. Just a bit of coconut. What else? Butter. Butter out and melt it nicely. So you want about 4 or 5 tablespoons of butter. There we go. We're gonna melt that in the microwave real quick. Working there full time. Yeah, you are there full time. 5 days a week. 9 to 5, or do you have different hours? Some weeks I do 32, pretty much 9 to 5 equivalent. Okay. You're working at prison. I don't know why I find that so funny, but he doesn't. He's just complaining. He works in IT. In an office that has no windows. Okay, more oats, I think. More coconut. It has mold. What? Can't you ask to like move into a different office? If it's got mold, then that's unsafe. These, if you add some more flour, you can just bake them and make them into cookies. Or like an egg as well. It's so good to eat, but not the healthiest. You wish you stayed with Mum. I'm setting a little bit more flour just because it's a little bit not crumbly enough. So very similar thing to this, we make Anzac biscuits that instead of brown sugar you use golden syrup. There is an escape. It was this job or the street. Brown sugar, butter and sugar is love, yeah. With some nice walnuts in there too. I think it needs more walnuts. I'm gonna use pecans in there as well. Okay. So we're not going to peel these. So you can chop, like get an extra apple, chop it, and then put it in there. But I don't want to do that. Okay. So there are multiple ways you can do this. What I'm going to do is it like this. So take the top off like that, and then we're going to use a melon bowler or a spoon, whatever you've got, what you want to do. Let's see what I've got. Are you not working tomorrow? I am not. I start my new job the next Monday. So you guys will see me. I'll be very, very nervous. But the thing is, tomorrow I'm gonna try my first train trip or bus trip or whatever. So that means I'm getting up early tomorrow. I'm gonna walk to the bus, and then I think I take a train. Got it all mapped out. So it takes an hour, and then I'll probably get another train or a bus to exceed. I might go and have a coffee with him in the morning, because he starts work at 6. My job starts at 7:30, so hopefully I'll be able to get there for his like first break tomorrow. Pressure cooker started. You're very disciplined to do that. Well, I really want to drive, but I can't drive if I haven't tried this out and said to exceed, you know, it's too hard, too long, or whatever. I need to actually, you know, physically go and do it. So I don't have one of those Quora things, so I'm just trying this out. You want to try and fit as much apple stuffing inside the apple as you can. So I'm just using a tablespoon to start. And at the tops of it, I just chopped up and put in there. Navigation is excellent, yeah. In the cars, yeah, Google Maps. We use Google for everything, you know that. Google Maps is very accurate. And you can also say to Google, you know, I want to arrive by this time. What just happened? On my shelf, what?
I don't know, something just happened inside the oven. Weird.
Okay, so it's nice and pretty. What I'm gonna do is use I'm gonna cut down. You don't want to cut all the way through. Just kind of get the seeds out. I used to have my brother used to have this corer that you just push through. Doing some baked apples right now. Just coring out some of the middle of these apples. We can. I think that will do. As much in it. So I made glass sleeve out of a rainbow loom bands, and I gotta say it's awesome. A glass sieve? What? So I made glasses. I don't know what that means. Translate that for me, is that? It's like it's a slip on the glasses. A slip on the glasses? Am I missing? Is this a game reference? For shirts, it's kind of like that, but it's for glasses. Oh my gosh! So you made them out of loom bands. Wow. How long did that take you? Don't do this at home. Don't cut yourself. I'm like ruining my teaspoon right now. Gotta have more room for crumble. Pain in the butt, I did eventually get it and probably a good hour. Oh wow. It's dedication, my friend. Okay. Right, I think that's good. So it says peel. No. Sorry, just ignore me. Okay, so this is our crumble. What we want to do is get chunks and push it right in like that. I regret putting the apple chunks in there, to be honest. Hoid, please don't do that. Except, do you mind? Ozzy, how you doing? How did your raid go? So you want to push them in like that. Ozzy, how's your nan doing? Your yaya. Someone needs to be with them. Okay. Oh wow! It's amazing. Very cool. Skyrim, that looks amazing. Okay, sorry. I'm gonna get out. Check out our roast. I'm gonna get my thermometer. Oh gosh, where did I put it? Hundred and twenty-four degrees Celsius. Still gotta cook a little bit longer, but there we go. That's our roast so far. It's looking damn delicious. What do you say myself? I'm gonna put our apples in there as well. I think what we'll do is we'll turn these into cookies. So I'm gonna eat them all. A bit more flour. An egg. It was a huge fight with the fam saying that she can look after herself, but the fam told me off. You said to them that she can look after herself? It's a pain to get on because it's rubber and it's hard. Ah, yeah. Show you another thing I made.
Sure.
Add some more cinnamon. Oh wow. Does it rub on your feet? Like the rubber? Does it rub? Like brides do them when they're getting ready. There we go, like an oatmeal cookie. Easy to put on so I don't like to wear it for too long. Alright, so baking paper made from our extra stuffing. It's like some apple oatmeal cookies. So I just added an egg and a little bit more oats and flour. You want these to be in a lower oven because the apples aren't cooked. So, if you don't want them to go brown. It'll be a nice snack. Oh, you're making me want some. That's the thing here. Bring snacks to the stream. Everybody gets hungry. People run off to do cooking. I used to say sorry for making people hungry, but I like it. Here we go. Okay, I'm getting cereal. Nice. But shoo! Excuse me. Oh my goodness, golly gracious. So you like making us hungry? Of course! It makes me feel good. Because it makes me feel as though the food that I'm making looks good. And you guys are liking. Thank you. Apple oatmeal cookies, I'm gonna call them. So, these leftover, you can just eat it, or the leftover stuffing for the apples, but it has brown sugar, one egg, plain flour, let me go through the ingredients first. Butter, brown sugar, flour, oats, cinnamon, and then we've added an egg in there as well, and some walnuts and coconut. Push it down like that. And I'll go into the oven. There's a lot of things in the oven at the moment. Put them at the bottom. Alright, so we've got about 20 minutes. Crashly, thank you for the host alerts don't seem to be popping up. But Crashly's just hosted us. Let's come up in chat. She's one of our Crash Fam members. She's the Crash Fam leader, actually. So go and check her out. She popped in our stream when we first started. It was about, we started streaming in April, I think. Maybe June, I think she popped into our stream, and then we've been friends ever since. Okay, I've decided to do chicken noodle soup. Oh my gosh. Skyrim, where in the world are you coming to us live from today? If you're making chicken noodle soup, it must be like daylight hours. It's a lot of work. Are we making the packet one? I wonder if Vixie had ever made that comment. He did! You're from Texas! Oh, nice. What time is it in Texas? Hey Google, what is the time in Texas? I don't know what's going on with Google, but she's a bit frozen lately. Hey Google, what's the time? Maybe it's the music that she can hear as well, I don't know. Come at me, girl. Alright, we're just doing some cleaning. Look at my new herb. So I don't know, I bought this to use, but it had some roots in it, so I replanted it.
Austin, Texas, USA, 4:52 a.m.
Thank you, that was a bit late, but thanks. Coming in with the goods. This is a basil plant. I thought I'd replant it, but it's getting a bit wilted. So I don't know if it'll be worth it. Maybe I'll just cut it off. Use all the basil and see what happens. Oh, damn, late. That's a herb. What the fuck? What do you mean? It's a basil plant. And it was canned soup, so he did it for a minute and it's done. Very nice. Very nice. Speaking of that, not all of my thoughts, I need to get some bread to serve with our stew. So I've got some nice sourdough. Nice piece of sourdough, and we'll put this in the toaster in a little bit later and serve it. Let's get out this pork, I think. We'll check it out. Harry Potter series, Skyrim. So we are doing in Three weeks we're going to do a Harry Potter stream. 3 or 4 weeks. So make sure you're following the stream and also you've joined our Discord because you're updated of the themes that we're going to be doing in the future. It's going to be a lot of fun. Did you guys have the heat wave today? Oh my gosh. We didn't. Yesterday was 40 degrees, like 45 degrees. Today was about 20 to 25, so we were nice and cool. But today in Sydney was the hottest day on record ever. It hit 47.5 degrees. Hey Google, what is 47 degrees Celsius in Fahrenheit?
47 degrees Celsius equals 116.6 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yeah, 116 degrees in Sydney today, and it was off like crazy. If Sydney and I were hot and it was 40, 45, well, it was mainly about 40, between 40, 43. And we were inside all day at night time. Hello! My Thick Lona. I was just trying to find out how to say your name, but I like it. My Thick Lona. What's going on? Welcome to the Molly Kitchen. We're just about to get our pork loin out of the oven. So we'll go down here. Put this here. Oh, Mythic! Oh, shit. Sorry. I just can't... I don't know how to... It could be my Thick Loner. Didn't have to be Mythic. Whatever. I'm just retarded. Sorry, guys. Sorry, Mythic. My bad. It's currently 3 degrees Fahrenheit. It's supposed to get to 30s. I like how Americans say it's hot, it's 30 degrees. Then I'm like, I've been in 40 degrees.
Yeah. Oh gosh, this looks good.
Look at that roast.
Yum.
So we have stuffed this with apple, cranberry, some breadcrumbs, walnuts. Let me get my thermometer now. Oh, still not the right temperature yet.
Yeah. Alright, we'll just clean up the edges
while we're here. We don't understand the Celsius witchcraft. We mean the metric system that the whole world uses except you guys. Tidying it up. Just taking some edges off. Yeah, just a little bit pink. Oh, look at that. It's so juicy. Yeah, 136, 140 degrees. Bit longer, I think. Lol, measure snap. You want hot, try South Florida. Look at that. I feel sad now. Now Mythic Luna hasn't said anything. Maybe they think that I'm a terrible person for saying their name wrong. I've scared them away, guys. Alright, look how juicy this meat is. This stuffing is to die for. Crunchy. Bits of apple, walnut. Shouldn't eat with my fingers. Mythic is a master lurker, don't worry. Oh, so tell Alexa, you know the person? Apologize for them that I called their name wrong. Alright. It's so hot in here. Okay. What are we gonna do? Alright, the meat's nearly done for the oxtail. The cookies are nearly done. I think we'll serve that in there. We'll put the stew in that bowl. You can serve the apples with some ice cream. We've got some ice cream in the fridge actually. Cool. People will be happy with that. I don't think I'm actually gonna cut. Pork. I don't know if I'll cut the pork. So I want it to look pretty, so we'll see. We'll see. Mainly, South Florida is hotter than Cali. Really? Is it more humid in Nebula and South Florida? what would the hottest state be? Would it be like Utah or Arizona? Where would you say the hottest state in the US is? Wow, that looks really good. Thank you. Hi, Beast. How you doing? How you doing? Look at all the stars in chat. It always astounds me. Instantly not close to Canada, but it is kind of close. What? Oh, isn't California's not close to Canada? California's more closer to Mexico. It's the bottom left-hand state. Let's give you a geography lesson in Molitopia. So this is Canada. This is the U.S. mainland U.S. This is Mexico here. This is California, where all these people are here. This is California, the bottom left-hand state. So California is on the border of Mexico. You get me? Is that right, guys? And Seattle is very humid. Oh my gosh, J Mood win. Stop talking and then I took a sip. When Exceed and I were in Seattle last year, the year before. Exceed and I were in Seattle for a Dota 2 tournament called the International. And it was so hot. Oh my goodness. It was just the worst. Do you remember, Exceed, how hot it was at nighttime? Like, it was cool during the day, and then at nighttime it just was so humid. There was no aircon. It was just, ugh. At the one stage, we had our door open. I was going to go out and sleep on the little balcony. They had this balcony this big. And I was going to sleep out there. It was terrible. Where is Washington, D.C.? Washington, D.C. is below. So this will be, here is New York City. Washington is where the, just below. So it's right, to the right and down, Washington, D.C. South of Baltimore, Maryland, yeah. A lot of people know where New York is, so it's easier just to be like, here and then down. Guys, the Beerix and Jess are just popped in chat, and we just want to give them a little shout out, because they have just got the most amazing merch. Their merch has arrived, and they were wearing it last night on stream, and it looks so dope. We are also working on some merch that is going to be coming out, some things. But I feel like now I'm embarrassed because it's not as cool as yours. Wrong coast, spell at me. Washington wasn't even close. Oh, it's New York. I thought it was closer to LA. Yeah, LA is on the left side, so in California. Yeah, how you doing, Briggs and Jess? Is it both of you? Or is Jess there? The assistant? All right. We're just gonna turn this slow cooker off. Got our cookies in there. We made some ad hoc cookie. You're cooking rice? No, it is our pressure cooker. Can I get a Molly knife set kit bag? Ooh, I don't know about that. Is Perth next to Sydney? No, Ella, you know that. Get out of here. My sister went to bed, she was wearing her pigtails. The two plaits. That makes me happy. Ozzy, I'll have to try and find you a knife bag. Most of Ozzy is in the West. Virix, you are pulling out your map and putting the pin on your globe was funny because he showed me the clip yesterday. Made me laugh. I need a Molly apron in my life. Talexia, we are releasing some merch soon. So you have to check it out. Maybe we have one. We've been doing a lot of research on quality for our merch. We understand that shipping prices can be exorbitant and also cost and things like that. So we want to make sure if you guys are buying something, it's something that we own ourselves and that we are really proud to sell. And we've ordered from about three different companies. And the first one was good, but they were Australian, and it would be really expensive for our friends, international. Whereas now we're looking at doing with a bigger company that ship worldwide. And sometimes they have promotions, sometimes they do free shipping. So Exceed has just got some products off them, and we're gonna see how that goes, because we really, like I said, we really wanna make sure that our quality is good. Like, we are so picky with our quality of our production, with the stream, we want to make sure that we're giving you guys the best products that we can. I used to live in the bush, it's crap. Black, Bella, you want a black apron? All right, love you, Molly. Love you too, Birix. Not bush, the outback. What are you guys talking about? I used to live in the outback, it was worse. I grew up in the outback on a farm. It's not as bad as people think. If you have merch, I'm pretty sure anyone here would be willing to pay shipping from Australia. No, I don't know. We'll see. I think that I want a capped price shipping, so it's the same for everybody. Have you guys looked at Skyrim gear? I haven't. Being in Australia, I'm used to paying ridiculous shipping to get here. Yeah, and that we just ordered some things as well, and it was just like, what? It's been, that's, you know, the ability to have weekends that are shipping, free shipping worldwide and things like that. Exceed went and bought, all these shirts from these streamers and things that he's been wanting to buy forever, but, you know, $20 to $40 in shipping. It costs more to ship than the actual shirt. It's just ridiculous. So that's what puts you off it. Whereas we want to be able to provide a product that can gonna get to you. We're also looking at working with a company that can personalize merch for you guys as well. That will do giveaways for hitting milestones or things like that. So, yeah. All right, I'm gonna get these cookies out. You paid $300 for a package? What? So our oatmeal cookies. This one is a merch store, and some of the proceeds go to charity. Oh, look at these cookies. Birix, when are you going back keto? Look at that. Okay. So we'll get a little plate for them. Oatmeal cookies. The keto ember burns in my, I don't want to talk about it. Don't worry, we're going much healthier, Birix. We're gonna be doing some keto recipes, some low carb, low sugar recipes, Monday to Friday, and then we'll get a little bit more relaxed. But Exceed and I are both focusing on getting healthy for the new year. We'll kind of let a few things like, you know, get relaxed, especially with the stream. So I've been getting back to the gym, I've been doing yoga every day. I believe my American friends of mine, when I told them how fuel vouchers work here in Australia and how much the fuel costs, yeah. Yep, our fuel is expensive. How is it different to the US? Do they not do the same? Oh, let me show these cookies. If I can break it open, because it's really hot. So full of apple, cinnamon, butter, brown sugar. So good. Mmm. Look at that. It's like an apple pie in a cookie. Allegra said I wanted it was $200 and I had to pay another $300. What? Oh my gosh, what Lego set? Was it made of gold? Keto would be impossible here. What do you mean? Alright. Our baked apples. Okay, and what we're gonna do, take some of this off, is get a ramekin like this. We're gonna fill some brown sugar with some butter. Brown sugar and butter. We're gonna make like a glaze and we're gonna pour them over our apples. The layered pull-apart bread was too testing. The cookies and breads, yes, it is hard. And that's why my health is getting, you know, it's been getting bad because it's just been so exciting making all this food that I want to make for everybody on stream. You know? So, butter and sugar into the microwave. About 15 to 20 seconds. Alright, I'm gonna depressurize this. It's gonna make a little bit of noise. Man, I get grumpy when it's more than $5 to ship something. Not like to live here then. Even to ship from like here back home, like to WA is $10. Like, so I sent, that was seven, but usually normal shipping is about $10. I sent things home today and each package cost me $7.50 and it was 400 grams. It was just, oh, beyond ridiculous, guys. Taking these little burnty bits off. The oven was a bit high because of the fork. But what you want to do is your brown sugar and butter. You just kind of put that over the top. And like a little glaze. Serve it with some ice cream in a little bit. This one's a bit shoddy, so we might use this one as a display item for you guys. So we'll take photos with that though, because it's a bit prettier. Okay, some ice cream.
I got this shopping wrong.
The skin's come off. Oh, I should forgot to poke it. Beerips. Burks. Whatever you want to be called. Oh no, my crumble fell off. This is our stuffed apples, our baked apples from Skyrim. And then we've got a brown sugar glaze and some ice cream as well. Rolled with, it's a bit hard to see with the light. I want some stuffed apples. So we'll let that sit there and all right, we're gonna make a gravy real quick. So how are we gonna do this, Molly? So my auntie and I would always fight over Crackle, and it was always her thing that my grandmother laughs about, and she always, it's a joke that my auntie Mandy always wants the Crackle. But I think everyone, as we've got older, everyone used to fight her for it. Alright, see all these pan juices? These are going to make a really nice gravy. You can just separate the lumps, and we'll do that in a minute. Put our pork to the side, and then what you're going to do is depressurize this. Molly, you got coincidentally lucky. The baked apple recipe is rooted in the Skyrim region of S. What do you mean? How did I get lucky? Is it not on Elder Scrolls Online? What? Is it not in the game? It is in the game. I just found out your website that you sent me. Alright, so this would manually do this if you left it, like to be, but I'm not a patient person, so I like to depressurize it. But that pressure itself, this isn't recommended, because what you're doing is that steam is actually flavor, and you want to let it settle gently. But don't be like me. Excited live? What do you mean? What would happen if you open it? You can't open it. There's a mechanism. See, I can't unlock it. is a pressure mechanism that it locks itself, and you can't actually unclick it until the pressure's released. Oh, you said these are the baked apples from Skyrim. Oops, I meant Elder Scrolls Online. The list I gave you didn't say where the loot was from the recipe. Okay, so I get what you mean, I was lucky. I never even seen a pressure cooker. It's amazing. It cooks things in a period of the time, rather like slow cooking, and there's a whole science behind it. Heston Blumenthal was actually, coincidentally, the face of the Fast Slow Cooker Pro. And it talks about, you know, infusing a lot of flavor into the meats and allowing them to break down, but also infusing a lot of flavor. You have to find the recipes in-game to make them, and the Skyrim region is where you get it. Ah, okay, cool. So Skyrim's a region. That's so cool. But it confuses me that Skyrim's a game. That's the thing that I was confused about. All right, so now it's, oh my goodness. Oh wow, the house smells incredible. Put that over there. Okay, now I have to remember to unclick it before I do this and bring it over. Our Jamaican oxtail stew. So what would happen is, usually I will let this put it on sear again. Look at all this meat, guys. It's just falling off the bone. Look at this. The meat, and that's been cooking for 40 minutes. And I'm just using a spoon. What I'll do is put some corn flour in there, or you can set it to sear and then it will bubble. Oh my gosh, that flavor. And then you want to reduce it. And okay, let's do two things at once. Eaten a warhead this room. It's my tongue is just, whew, has a time to calm down. Because yesterday I was eating like at Heston and I was thinking, God, thank God we're not paying all this money for this food and I've got like a burnt tongue. Oh my God, everything looks incredible, too incredible. Going to sleep with oxtail on the brain. See you, Liz Lemon, says Exceed. Bye, Limping Lemon. Hope you have a lovely sleep. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Okay, in here, what we're gonna do is set this to the sear function. Okay, I'm gonna get some corn flour. You could, if you had some time, you could just let it reduce like that. But it will take quite a long time on stream to reduce down. And see how you have this layer of oil at the top? If you were to cool it down, you could take off a lot of that oil and then reduce it. So that's what I usually do as well if I'm not cooking on stream. Or even if I am, when after it's cooked, I'll put it in the fridge and then the next day I'll skim that off before I reheat it. So I've just put some corn flour in here, also with some water. We're just gonna put that in there. And then that's gonna heat and cook that corn flour and thicken the sauce nicely. You would serve this with some rice or some mashed potato even. Whatever you like, it's nice Jamaican spicy flavor, so rice would probably be the best, or even pasta. Or vegetables as well. We can add some celery and carrot to add some more bulkiness to it. All right, we're gonna quickly go to the stove. I'm gonna make this gravy. Glaze from the skin. Okay. Feeling hungry? Yeah, I'm so hungry. Alright. Are you guys feeling hungry? Juice. See how that's gone white because of the cornflour? You see as the cornflour cooks that it will go back to clear. I'm actually going to put all that in. White wine to this as well. Oh my goodness. See, it's going clear and nice and brown. Oh, yum. Nice bit of sweetness from that beautiful cranberry and apple. You've got, be aware you've got the saltiness from the skin that I put on top. So you don't want to make it, when you're adding the salt to the top, you don't want to make it too sweet. You don't want to make it too sweet. Rip camera, what happened? Oh, because it's so... Okay, that should stop soon. Do you ever add white pepper? I don't buy white pepper just because it's like a second ingredient to buy. And I don't know if it makes that much of a difference, but I would like to diversify. Does a spoon scratch? That is a cheaper saucepan. So I'm not really worried about it, but I'm being gentle, very gentle. Yeah, you should ideally use a spatula. Oh my gosh, this is so good. And then you can just get these like lumps out, sieve it through, we'll get a sieve. We'll do it properly. Clean the stove, Cam, it's smudged. Oh, is it? It's because of all the steam. Better? Nope, that was worse. Nope, that's even worse. Let me get a Windex. Dancing in darkness to the sound of a drum. should give you my mom's recipe for pepper nuts. It's a cookie bowl thing. 5 types of pepper, ginger, cinnamon, and nutmeg. Oh. A cookie bowl. I've never heard of anything like that. Okay. I'm gonna get the stew. So our Jamaican style oxtail stew. Perfect for your character in Elder Scrolls, or even just you. Look at that. Unplug this, move that away. Ooh, shivers. Scared the crap all out of me. Last but not least, we better cut this hay. Cut them open. Sound that crackle. Man. Oh, I found when I was cleaning out, if I can find it again. What? Where is it? It's like the carving fork. I cleaned up. Oh, here we go. Carving fork. Though you want desserts with booze in it, I can send you a recipe for boozy apple pie. Ooh. I don't drink. Thank you, though. Sorry, Birix, I shouldn't laugh. Oh goodness, I kind of ruined it, but. Look how pretty that looks. So our millet, cranberry, and apple stuffed pork loin. Let's see if we can get it in order. There we go. Domi Tsunami, how you doing? Can we get a Crash Fam shout out for Domi, please? He's one of our Crash Fam members. Okay, so this is, I guess, sorry. An Elder Scrolls Online episode. So our stream where we do a gamer grub, themed food from videos, TV shows, and movies. And thank you to Link Nightblade for redeeming enough Molly dollars to choose a theme. So this is the pork loin. What we've done is we've used some apple, cranberry, what else? Apple, cranberry, walnuts, panko breadcrumbs, some millet, or you could use brown rice or oats, whatever you like. We've wrapped that in a pork loin. I showed you how to butterfly it and then roll it up with some twine. And then we've made a really nice gravy with all the pan juicings. Look at that. I'm pretty proud of that. Pretty impressed. You're playing Wildlands. Oh my gosh, I want to get that game. Okay, and then with we're going to dessert. So this is our stuffed apple, stuffed or baked apples. And so we've done a stuffing with some brown sugar, oats, butter, walnuts in there as well, and some coconut. And then we've done, this one doesn't look as pretty because I was eating it, but we've done a glaze with some brown sugar and butter, served it with some ice cream. With the leftover filling, we made some cookies. We added some egg in there and some more plain flour and made some apple oatmeal cookies that taste like an apple crumble or an apple crisp. And last but not least, this is our beef ox or oxtail stew or beef tail stew. We put this in our pressure cooker. So we're using Jamaican spices. So allspice, some chili. You could use the recipe calls for scotch bonnet, but whatever you've got, whatever you like really. Allspice, some tomato paste. I use some liquid smoking to make it a little bit smokier. Paprika, stock in there as well. And then you could serve that with some vegetables or just a nice piece of some bread like that. And so nice Jamaican flavors going on in there. And that's it. It's fun time, especially with friends. Lovely. So guys, this is our Elder Scrolls Online. Oh, just can't reach to that one. Look at that. Beautiful. All rich foods, you're gonna be eating good tonight. Yeah, it's definitely a feast. Food that's gonna be, keep us going for the next few days. Thank you, Link, for that beautiful idea. All right, guys, this week we are making some bang on delicious food. So no cook tomorrow. We're gonna be back in one day in 20 hours. We're gonna be making some lasagna rolls, some lasagna roll-ups. We're also gonna do some fruit roll-ups as well, fruit leather. We're gonna try a hand at that. A lot of healthier alternatives, a lot of really delicious food as well. And then on Sunday, we are gonna be doing Irish cuisine for Miss Molly Makes Around the World. So that means Irish soda bread, beef and Guinness stew, beef and Guinness pie, and then also some lemon pudding as well. So it's gonna be a good one. Make sure if you're new to the channel, hit that follow button so you're notified when we're live. And then we're gonna send our love to another creative streamer. Let's see who we can host. Oh, hey. Who can we host? Let's go over to Danielle. So guys, thank you so much for staying around. Thank you for all of the lovely comments. Make sure you join our socials and we'll see you on Tuesday. See everybody. For those going back to work, good luck. Love to you all. Bye-bye. There's a roar outside my door. Is what you're looking for. Flower child, you're born to run. Following the western sun.